Your Steve Jones Show podcast is loading now. The Steve Jones Show podcast is sponsored by Purdy Insurance. Visit Purdy Insurance on Market Street in Sunbury or visit online at purdyinsurance.com. Sports talk where your voice counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Good afternoon, everybody. It is the Steve Jones Show as we start a new week. Matt Catrillo back here with you in the producer chair, fresh off of vacation. It's good to be back here with you. Thanks again to everybody that filled in for me last week. Chad Hirschberger, our new boy Max Troutman, The Suit. Thanks to all of them for all their help while I was gone last week. And Steve will soon be there, as he always is, from the Sunbury Motors Studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. And online at sunburymotors.com. Ford, Kia, Hyundai, lots of pre-owned inventory. A great service department and sales staff that will simply get it done for you. It's all part of the Sunbury Motors guarantee. That service department is there with the diagnostics, with the inspections, with it all, and the sales staff, not just there for the sale, but of course, there for you. And it's all at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. And every Monday show brought to you by our good friends at Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury, or go to purdyinsurance.com. Home, auto, life, business, RV, boats, you name it, they have it. They'll get you covered for what you need for all insurance matters. They are the true pros in that field. And it's all at Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury, or go to purdyinsurance.com. Michael DeCourcy today from Sporting News and BTN will join us. Lots to get into with him in terms of the current college sports landscape, especially in college football. Get into more on that in a second, just for my own observations from the SEC meetings last week. But news coming down today, Penn State Letterman, Kajana Carter, DJ Dozier, Paul Posluszny, all selected as part of the national ballot for the National Football Foundation's College Hall of Fame class of 2023. Total of 80 players and 9 coaches from the FBS are on the 2023 ballot. And the trio of standouts have an opportunity to join 20 former Nittany Lion players, including, of course, LeVar Arrington, who will be inducted later this year, and 5 Penn State coaches who have been inducted into the Hall. Also on the Hall of Fame ballot is the former Nittany Lion student-athlete Glenn Killinger, who was among the candidates for the divisional coach class of 2023. Taylor Stubblefield also made the ballot as a player, of course, was a consensus All-American and finalist for the Bill and Koff Award given to the nation's most outstanding receiver. So congrats to all of them, and lots of good names there for Penn State to see if they can get into the College Football Hall of Fame. We'll find that out in early 2023. So we have that posted at stevejonesshow.com. Now getting back to the SEC meetings, from what I saw from about 30,000 feet on the beach last week, it seems like we're pretty much back to civility, but at the same time, the problems are still there in terms of how do we handle NIL going forward? How do we handle all the boosters getting involved and all those sorts of topics that we've talked about in the last couple of weeks? That's still far along on the table. That is going to continue to create this circus that's been in college sports as we start looking towards the fall. So, I was a little bit surprised. I still thought there would be some shots fired a little bit, but cooler heads have prevailed down there in the big, mighty SEC. So there you have it there. Other news that has come across earlier today, things are not getting better for Deshaun Watson. He now has a 24th lawsuit, a lawsuit from a 24th woman against him for inappropriate sexual conduct during massage sessions. So that continues to not go so well in the Browns' favor. Still haven't heard any word yet from the NFL in terms of a possible suspension, discipline, whatever that is. Another interesting NFL note today, the 49ers have excused Jimmy Garoppolo from mandatory minicamp. And perhaps now that could pave the way for his eventual departure from the team. And it's been speculated all offseason long. He's still with the team at this point. So we'll see how that goes. Steve Jones, it is good to be back with you, sir.
Who are you throwing at now?
Oh, I'm just reading through the latest headlines. Things still not getting better for Deshaun Watson. Jimmy Garoppolo's getting an excuse from minicamp, so it looks like he'll eventually get traded. But we got some Nittany Lions in there, too, in the College Football Hall of Fame ballot, so that's cool to see.
Yeah, Paul Posluszny, Kajana Carter, DJ Dozier.
Yep.
But what's interesting is the last thing I want to do is talk about Deshaun Watson. Does anybody doing this job want to talk about Deshaun Watson? I mean, really. But now it's a 24th accuser. So let's get into a couple of quick things with it. Number one, you know, what haven't the Browns done? Let's find out if you get any sharper while you're on vacation.
Well, I mean, I guess ever since they first made the trade, they've kind of kept quiet, and we're all kind of waiting on what the NFL is going to be doing.
No, that's not it. Okay. All right, this is what they haven't done. They haven't dealt Baker Mayfield.
That is also true. He is still on the roster, awkwardly enough.
Yeah, I know it's true. I said it.
But again, a part of that probably could be is so they have somebody in case he does get handed down a suspension.
That's my point. Mandatory OTAs for the Browns are next week. You mentioned Jimmy Garoppolo being excused. So far, that has not happened with Baker Mayfield. Okay, so that's one. Watson, the deal the Browns gave him is off the charts. If Watson is suspended for the season, which I think is a distinct possibility from 30,000 feet, he loses $1 million. That's it. The other 45, there is. Right. Who in Cleveland, and the running joke among Pittsburgh fans is it's the Browns being the Browns. It's always been the running joke. Okay. Who did their due diligence on this? Who? Who sat back? Because a grand jury did not indict him. You're sitting in Cleveland, and that's good enough. But you got 23 accusers. And I said, he's going to go through one after another. I said this at the time. You're going to have one after another in their suit. Well, today you got a 24th one. Now let's get to something that is really that is really eyebrow-raising. Athletes are very particular about their body. It's what it is, what makes their livelihood. So they'll rely on probably the same one or two trainers. They will rely on the same strength and conditioning person. You know, they hire their own entourage, their own team. Well, part of any athlete, especially today, is recovery. Recovery is critical. Recovery from a workout, recovery from a practice, recovery from a game. So that could be a combination of hot tub, cold tub, right? Or massage, right? And most athletes will go out there and they want to be with somebody who knows them. Hey, remember that problem with my back? You know that one area in the lower left? You don't really have to get into specifics with them. Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. They know you. All right? Ask yourself, why did this guy have 24 of them? I rest my case. See where I'm going here? It just, like, doesn't...
Yep.
Doesn't, I mean, it doesn't add up. And the Browns, it's not, this is, if the Houston Texans had drafted him like he had in this trouble, that nobody would be looking at the Texans and saying a word about them. But with all of this going on, the Cleveland Browns openly acquired him to be the face of the franchise. Really? Unreal. All right, Celtics and Warriors are tied at a game apiece. Warriors last night took the Celtics apart in winning it. Celtics had a golden opportunity in the first quarter. They were up 9. And just, they've got to understand what John Wooden said decades ago. Okay? Be quick. Don't hurry. The Celtics try to go too fast. That's why they get their pocket picked. That's why they make errant passes. They're trying to go too fast. Be quick. Don't hurry. Okay? The ball is the franchise. Take care of the franchise. They turn it over too often. Far too often. And they had a chance when the Warriors were doing nothing in the first quarter to build up maybe, I mean, to be honest with you, the Celtics could have built up a 20-point lead in the first quarter. Instead, they're down 1 at the end of the first quarter, and you knew they weren't going to win it. As for Draymond Green, he got the one tee. He probably should have had the other one with Jaylen Brown. You watch that play. All right, he fouls Brown. Yeah, he got him. And he lands on him, and his legs land on Brown. And then Brown sits up, and look, he doesn't push or shove him, but he nudges him from behind. Hey, your legs are on top of him because Brown didn't touch him. All right? So get your legs off of him. Brown can't get up. What are you nudging him for? He can't get up. You're laying on him. And then Brown gets up, and he grabs him by the shorts and yanks himself up. Like, what? Brown never touched him. Crazy. Now, do I give him a T in that spot? No. But he says, I've earned deferential treatment from the referees. Actually, you haven't. But that's, you know, oh well. there's no question you love how hard he plays. He always has played hard. But he's, you know, he's also a pain in the neck, believe me. I mean, I can go back to a couple stories of when he played against Penn State. Jeez. Like, I'm telling you right now, Penn State blew out Draymond Green and Michigan State in the Big Ten Summer Finals in 2011. During the regular season, Green had a meaningless basket at the end of the game. Penn State scored a meaningless basket at the end of the game at the Breslin Center. And Green grabbed the ball right away and threw it the length of the floor. And the reason he did, he was trying to complete a triple-double. And the Penn State players went at him. It was, you know, it's like, what are you doing? Right. Then they got to the semifinals of the Big Ten tournament. Penn State game was tied at halftime and blew them out in the second half. It was an easy double-digit win, and Green the second half did not play well at all. But, yeah, he's always had that kind of little edge to him. Now he's on your team, you love him. He's on your team, you love him. He's on the opposing team, can't stand him. In other words, if he were playing for the Yankees, Matt would just, oh, he's the greatest guy going. But if you were playing for the Dodgers, I mean,
either way, I would find him nauseating, so I'm not on that bandwagon.
If you're playing for your team, come on. You think Josh Donaldson, come on. You think Donaldson's awesome?
He's our guy. He won the game for us yesterday. He's so good. We love him. It's June.
All right.
He did his job, but I'm not jumping up and down about him.
He's your guy. All right. By the way, LIV Golf did release their field for their first event this weekend. And out of nowhere, the last name added was Phil Mickelson.
Oh, my almighty!
Yep. It is a... they put together a 48-man, 12-team tournament. There were a half dozen names omitted. It turned out that the last player to fill the final spot was Phil. There you go. So he's playing this weekend. All right. Interesting show today. Matt's back from vacation. Already just had no clue about the Baker Mayfield thing. So, I mean, nothing's changed. I thought maybe a rest would do you some good.
I might still be on the beach. I don't know.
You were on the beach before you left. What are you talking about?
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
We'll come back with more in a moment on News Radio 1070 WKOK, brought to you by our good friends at Purdy Insurance.
When car repairs get difficult.
Well, I just don't know.
Me neither.
We get good. Sunbury Motors. More than quality new and used cars, Sunbury Motors specializes in complicated auto repair diagnosis. They can handle intricate repairs and even complete auto body with service open Monday through Friday, 7 till 4. And Sunbury Motors has made simple repairs easy. Maintaining your vehicle is necessary. Finding the time to do it is difficult. Welcome to Sunbury Motors Quick Lane. Open 7 till 4, Monday through Friday. Just walk in or call ahead. Relax in their remodeled waiting room with Wi-Fi, beverages, and snacks. Will Sunbury Motors factory trained techs take care of your oil change, tire alignments, brakes, and inspections. Quick Lane, 6:30 to 6, Monday through Friday, Saturday, 6:30 till 2. Sunbury Motors, Ford and Hyundai, North 4th Street, Sunbury. And Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. We take the out of auto repair.
Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now, from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
So I just want to know if there's anything you hate right now.
Not a whole lot, to be honest with you. It was nice seeing the Celtics get crushed in the second half last night. It was nice to see the Rangers lose in heartbreaking fashion to the Lightning. Yankees have the best record in baseball.
The Celtics go to San Francisco and they get a split. Last I checked, that's called like achieving a goal.
It was still nice to see them crushed.
What about 44-16 in the fourth quarter in game one? Who crushed who? Do you watch the games?
Yeah, that wasn't pleasant.
Yeah, what are you talking about? I think they got a split. You want to play fast, but there are times where the ball has to go the same speed that you're going, and that to me is the Celtics' biggest downfall. And give credit, I thought the Warriors played really good defense last night, really good defense. But the problem is, the Celtics compound the problem by trying to play too fast. Just me. That's what I'm seeing from them. Got to slow down just a little bit. Today's show brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury, go to purdyinsurance.com. Auto, home, life, business, motorcycle, boat, whatever your insurance need may be. They'll take care of it at Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury, go to purdyinsurance.com. And they'll do everything they can to save you money. Last I checked, saving money is more important than ever. And you want to make sure you're fully insured across the board more than ever. It's all at Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. We're in the Sunbury Motors studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15, Hummel's Wharf, online at sunburymotors.com. All right. What? You wanted to jump in there with something profound? Or?
No, we just had a caller ask about, I guess, individual single game tickets going on sale for Penn State home games, football home games, going on, I guess, this week. I guess they're not announcing how much tickets are. You have to, sign in. He wanted to know if you knew anything about that.
No. Okay. I don't. As a matter of fact, I do not know in terms of what the process is like. And that's part, that is because I don't have to do it. I never really have thought much about it, so I apologize to the caller. I always know when season tickets go on sale and when the student ticket stuff goes on sale and when, on individual tickets. I know when things happen, but the process of doing it, I don't know because I've never had to do it before. Sorry about that. My apologies. It's something I can't answer. Great question, but it's something I can't answer. And part of it is, again, because I don't have to go through the process. And I'm just we can get a. Hope we get a better answer for you than that, so sorry about that. All right. I'm glad you have nothing to complain about. Yeah, by the way, your guy John Sterling is going to miss a lot of games this season.
I know. I just saw this. So I'm just reading through it now. I mean, I can't say I'm surprised. He's 84, for Pete's sake, but
no. I mean, no. Basically, he's saying he's had enough. That's what he's saying. being around this group. He's I guess Josh Donaldson drove him out.
No, senor! No, senor! No, senor!
Listen, he's a dope, but that can't be the reason.
I'm just joking. I don't really. Why do you think I care? I mean, come on. Come on. Don't care. What he's going to do is this. Is he's going to miss the only games that he will do in the second half of the season will be Yankee Stadium, Citi Field, Camden Yards, Fenway Park. That will be it. So.
And do you know who's in the running for some candidates?
Ricky Ricardo,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, buddy.
No, senor! No, senor! No, senor!
To be honest with you, I think that he would be the guy. I know they've talked about Ryan Rucco. They've talked about...
Yeah, that's also not surprising because he fills in on yes for Michael Kay from time to time.
Yeah. When we've had Ricky on the show, what, four times? I think something like that. And when you listen to Ricky, Ricky is the Spanish language announcer for the Philadelphia Eagles and Spanish language announcer for the Yankees. But when we have him on the show, obviously, we're just talking, right? Can any of you tell in a million years he's the Spanish language announcer for the Eagles and the Yankees? No. He'd be great. Not just good. He would be great filling in for John Sterling. My opinion. I think he'd be great. Love to see it. I think Yankee fans would love it.
I would love it myself.
You don't like anybody, so it's, you know. You're anti-human beings. I was kind of hoping vacation would settle you down. You came back. I mean, you're still filled with hate.
I am who I am, I guess.
Okay. All right. No, I mean, I'm watching all those, Bill Self, Joel Embiid commercials. God, you guys couldn't even get out of the second round. What the heck? Oh, well. See, let me make one. It's a point I made last week when you weren't here, but I'll make the point again. The idea of the process, which I hated. I can't stand the idea of it.
Me too. I was the exact same way.
I can't stand the idea of it. Netted them one player. Joel Embiid, a transcendent, great player. But Okafor? No. Nerlens Noel? No. Right?
Talk about two disasters right there.
Right, but that's part of the process. Noel was a sixth overall pick. Okafor was, what, third, fourth?
Yes.
Fourth overall
third.
Pick, something like that. Right? They got Ben Simmons, whom I did not like at LSU. Didn't like him at LSU. I was like, oh, okay, really? Okay, Markel Fultz.
Oh, that was probably the biggest disaster of them all.
And they drafted Mikal Bridges. And traded him 10 minutes later for the kid from Texas Tech, who right now is in the witness protection program.
Yes.
Thank you. That's the process. Now let's flip it to the two teams in the finals. The Warriors drafted Steph Curry in the first round. The Warriors drafted Klay Thompson. the Warriors in the second round drafted Draymond Green. That is the core of their team. And they had to wait a few years. You know, when they drafted these guys, it was not instantaneous. They had to wait a few years before it finally fell into place for all of them. Yes, they added in Kevin Durant for two of the three championships. No question. But the core group is still there and together. The Celtics drafted Marcus Smart, I think it was eighth overall. Drafted Jason Tatum, third overall. Drafted Jaylen Brown, third overall. That's the core of their team. Yeah, they added in Al Horford. It's made a big difference for them. They, you know, they midseason they picked up White, but they both went out and they both drafted the core guys on their team. Right? And they didn't, and neither team tanked. They didn't tank. I mean, Golden State wasn't very good, you know, there were some issues, but they didn't go out and tank. This is before anybody ever talked about tanking. They were able to get Curry. They looked at him and said, hey, look, you know. And then they were able to get Thompson because they looked at, you know, there's a way of playing. Maybe we can play this way with the rules. You know, Green, second round, they get lucky. You got to get lucky once in a while.
And Boston got lucky, too, getting the number one overall pick the year they got Tatum.
Well, because they traded.
Yeah.
They made the right trade. They took older players, and they got rid of them. Okay? And then they made the deal with the Sixers, and the Sixers could have had Tatum. Tatum was the third overall pick. Fultz was the first pick. Celtics had the first pick. Traded it to the Sixers. And the Sixers did exactly what the Celtics hoped they would do. I watched Fultz at Washington. I said, I don't get it. I don't see it. I even said it the day after on the show. I said, I don't get it. I said it the next day after on the show. I said, the Celtics got the biggest steal of the draft. They got Jason Tatum. Now, is Tatum the best player in the league? No. Is he one of the top 15 players in the league? Yeah. But that's what the process and all that losing netted you. Essentially, one guy. You got Ben Simmons as a second guy, first overall pick. You dealt him. You got Harden. And Harden just went through a playoff where, you know, for the umpteenth time in his career, nothing happened. Trying to think if anybody saw that coming.
I think I may have known a certain someone to have said that.
Like the day after the day of the trade? Yeah. May, if God, you were so mad at me. Still waiting for apologies. All right. So You're like, no. Like, settle down. It's all right.
This is the greatest trade ever. It's the greatest trade since the Yankees got Babe Ruth.
What? So, that's how, but each team, in other words, made their deals, the Warriors and the Celtics, knowing they were not going to get instant gratification from doing it. Right? It took the Warriors a little bit longer than the Celtics. But boy, once they got there, boy, they got there. Meanwhile, Sixer fans suffered watching them do this BS way of building a team. You drafted Bridges. It was one of your best picks. You dealt him. I couldn't believe. I sat back. When they picked Bridges that night, I thought, "Wow, what a even texted Dick, what a savvy pick that was. Absolutely.
I know. I was pumped. I went from pumped to throwing stuff at the TV.
I said that because I said, yes, now I know how Cleveland Browns fans feel. Jeez. That was,
I mean, that's what netted them.
The process. That's why, to me, you always play to win. Always play to win. Always play to win. Because anytime you're looking to constantly do something for the future, you have no present.
And, oh, by the way, look at Drew Holiday, who the Sixers had and nearly brought them to a conference final a couple of years ago against those Celtics.
Yeah. Holiday's interesting. I think Holiday's a good player. He's not a great player. He's a good player. And if Philadelphia kept him, I mean, you know, you've got a Holiday, you dealt Jimmy Butler.
I still see fault at both sides. I think Jimmy Butler's a goof, but the Sixers also messed that up as well.
Jimmy Butler and Ben Simmons are not in the same... It doesn't take a genius to see they're not in the same plane as a player. Ben Simmons isn't even remotely in Jimmy Butler's category as a player. The Sixers kept hoping Ben Simmons would be great. But I'm sorry. You know, you're playing in the National Basketball Association. You got to be able to shoot. You'd be shocked how you become a more effective passer when actually people have to respect the fact you're going to shoot. And I do like the fact Simmons is an excellent passer, no question. And he actually is a really, really good defender. But you got to be able to shoot at some point. That's why I never liked him at LSU. I watched him all year. I didn't like him. And a lot of times when I'm watching guys, every once in a while you make a mistake on somebody. I'll give you a guy I absolutely made a mistake on. All right? Okay? Just to, you know... Because I can look at myself and know, I didn't get that one right. It's a baseball player, Austin Meadows. Austin Meadows is a good major league player. I didn't say great, awesome, and incredible. I said Austin Meadows is a good major league player, right? When he played here, and he played here several times. I mean, a bunch of times he played. I remember watching him going, okay, I don't see it. And I'm watching him, it's like, I don't see it. He gets to the major leagues. Guess what? He is a good major league player. I did not get that one right at all. But a lot of times you can tell. Football, basketball, baseball, you can tell right away when somebody has it, you know, that you think can get there, be good, whatever. Simmons, I didn't see it. Fultz, I didn't see it. Austin Meadows, I didn't see it, and guess what? He's of the three of them, he's the one that, you know, he ended up being, he is a good major league player, and I was wrong about him. The other guys, I don't think I was wrong about. Oh, the other part, I was right about the suit last week, too. Jeez. All right, back with more in a moment. Here at News Radio 1070 WKOK.
SUIT, that spells suit!
In an ever-changing world, one thing you can always count on is the service at Purdy Insurance. Hi, this is Season. While the world is constantly changing, Purdy Insurance is dedicated to providing you with the highest level of service to protect you, your family, and your business. Give us a call today at 570-286-5855. Go to our website at purdyinsurance.com or check us out on Facebook to see what Purdy Insurance can do for you.
Long day of baseball on this Sunday. Bills fans looking for some heroics from Harper. Here's the 3-2. Swung on. Crushed. He's done it. How about that? Four heroics into the second deck as Bryce Harper has tied this game. on a 3-2 pitch here in the bottom of the eighth inning. It's 6-6 on Harper's sixth career grand slam.
Runners will be off. There they go. The pitch. Breaking ball hit high and deep right field. Back is Lagares.
And it is gone.
Yeah.
Bryson Stott wins it. Bryson Stott with his second career home run, and it's his first ever walk-off in the big leagues. And the Phillies have come back to win this game over the Angels. Stott throws the helmet in the air, and they celebrate at home plate around the rookie.
Now four games under 500, way to go. All right, so what? No? Not what you wanted?
All I'll say is that came at the request of the suit, or else I wouldn't be a sports fan, apparently.
No, it's Scott Fransky with two great calls. Bryson Stott, who was a guest on our show. So Bryson, we've never had Bryce Harper on.